Grand North America, Northwest Venue, the Lakers to Sharansa of the chapter visiting the school in Asma. My dear friend, 2 days earlier, I told you about the explanation of the same chapter in English about Prashant. Prashant has gone to meet to his friend to block her butter, Rashma. This is a small town located in Odisha for a period of 1 day only. And he went to meet to his friend. When 7 years had passed of the death of his mother, he had gone there on 27 October 1999. But as soon as he reached there, and at the time of night when he was sleeping, then suddenly a storm along with heavy raining and winds came. The storm was very terrible, was very dangerous, and the same storm within a few time was changed into a cyclone. Due to this, the trees had uprooted and some trees had fallen down. Also, some houses were also fallen down and mixed into dust. Now, only the houses were remaining, which were made of brick or stone. Besides this, each and everything was fallen down or was damaged. Only the water was being seen everywhere. And how did Prashant pass his 2 days on the top of his friend's house? From here, the first question is started. As soon as he saw, Prashant saw that water was everywhere. Besides water, nothing was being seen on the ground. And the water came till the throat of human. So therefore, Prashant's friend and his family wanted to pass the life by living on the roof of the house. Prashant also took rest by living with his friends and his family member. But now also the weather was not clear. He saw that the water was everywhere, and besides water, nothing was being seen by anybody else. When he was on the roof of the house of his friend, at that time, a tree also had fallen down on the house. Due to this, some part of his friend's house was also damaged. He was also unable in order to eat something else. And the same condition was also of his friends as well as his family members. Now come to question number 2. What did Prashant do for the orphan children? After 2 days of the arrival of cyclone along with heavy rain and heavy wind, Prashant reached to his house after crossing all the circumstances with the help of a stick. And when he was coming into the way, then he saw various type of carcasses of the human men, women, animals, dogs, floating into the water of Venice. He also met to two friends of his cousin, and with the help of them also he reached to his house. As soon as he reached to his house, then he saw his all the family members were in the shelter. 86 persons of his village had died, or we can say they had lost their lives, and 96 houses had been damaged. The population of his village was near about 2,500. So therefore, whatever the person was left there, they were only orphans or widows. Orphans or widows. For orphan children and widows, he also arranged some clothing for them. And also told them in order to lay down on the clothing. Also told them to take rest. Also arranged some food and boiled rice. And then some medicine also. Not only this, but also he organized, he arranged a sport ground in order to play cricket, along with all the children, all the orphans, and all the persons who were available there at that time. And the men were engaged by him in order to arrange the food and clothing, water. It was also done with the help of NGO, non-government organization. For non-government organization, he also became a team of some persons whose duty was in order to arrange the food and clothing to the orphan children as well as the widows and women. What was the scene of destruction around the house of Krishan's friend? What was the terror of the family? As soon as he saw coming of the heavy rain as well as cyclone and caravan winds. Within a few men, he saw that the land of Prasant's place was full of water, and the raining water came with the neck of human. He saw that some trees had uprooted and some of the trees had been damaged or fallen down, and some houses also were fallen down. Only the houses which were made of stone or bricks, they were remained only. Besides this, each and everything was damaged. Also saw some carcasses of the animal, of human, dogs, floating into the water of raining. And he was also unable to come from his friends to his house. But in spite of it also, he came to his house, to his village, with the help of a stick as well as with the help of two persons of his who was a friend of his cousin. And he saw also the terror condition of the village. And the condition, terror condition was that the village was completely full of water. Nobody else was being seen as Alim. When he walked here and there along the village, then he saw coming maternal grandmother, and with the help of his maternal grandmother, he reached to the center's location where his only family members were staying. Uncle, aunt, brother, sister, and all. Now he became very pleased. But for a few times, he also became very afraid. So therefore, we can say that the family's condition was very, family's condition was in the condition of terror. As they were trembling, much, what to do, how to eat the food, where to live, and what to wear. These were all the problems related to roti kapda aur makan. But no facility was being seen by them. So therefore, they were not pleased because of the lack of this problem, of this facility. However, the orphans and widows disappeared. And so, the miserable condition of the orphans and widows without shelter, also without eating the food and without wearing the clothes. Then he went to the rep of government and he requested and advised them in order to settle the orphans and widows at least, because they can be settled by community. As there was not also any source with the son by which he could give such type of arrangement for them. Now come to question number 5. Why was it difficult for the son to come back in his village? Apne gaon mein aane ke liye kyon the son को बहुत सारी परेशानियां आ रही थी. As soon as the cyclone, the heavy wind, the raining became huge, then he started to move from there with the help of a stick. When he was coming into the water of raining, then he saw that the water was coming up to his neck. So therefore, he was unable to come from the water to his house. But in spite of it also, he did not lose his heart. And then he met two persons of the friend of his uncle. And with the help of them, he reached to his house, to his village. By seeing the miserable condition of his village, he became very afraid for a few times. And when he saw his maternal grandmother, then he became happy. Then he went to shelter where he saw his all the family members, as uncle, aunt, brother, sister, and all, whatever was in his family. When he was coming into the way for his village, then he saw so many carcasses, so many dead bodies, so many corpses of animals, dogs, and humans. And by seeing this all, he became very afraid. And so afraid that he did not want to come back to his village. But in spite of it also, for the sake of his own family members, he came back to his village. And his family members were waiting for the son. Describe the destruction caused by super cyclone. As soon as the son went, in order to pass one day only at the house of his friend's house, in Assama, located in Odisha, which was only 18 kilometers far from his village. That was also a block headquarter, as well as a small town. And after a few minutes, he saw coming a cyclone and heavy wind and heavy raining. Within two moments, he saw that the land of his village became full of water completely within two moments. Also, he saw that the trees had uprooted and some trees had fallen down or had been damaged. And some houses also had been damaged, or some houses which were left, they were remained only, which were made of brick or stone. Besides this, nothing was such which can be said as Ali. Water was also everywhere, and water was coming to the neck of the woman. Then he came to his village after 2 days of the cyclone, and he saw the same situation also. His village was also full of water. His village was also full of destruction, as the trees had uprooted, houses also had been damaged, the trees also had been fallen down, and some animals, dogs and some women were also seen by him floating into the water of raining as dead body. And whatever the persons were alive, they were also unable in order to arrange for eating, for wearing clothes, and for shelter. These are all the destruction caused by super cyclone. Not only this, but also the crops harvest have been also damaged, and the environment was completely useless. And it was destructed because of the arrival of cyclone, as well as winds and heavy raining. But when the son came to his village, then he arranged food, clothing and shelter for all persons, and mostly for orphans, widows and women, and all persons. Not only this, but also he called military helicopter in order to provide some parcel of food. And the same helicopters continued to come there till a long time. Not only this, but also he arranged a sports ground in order to play cricket with the children, with all the persons who are interested. He also met to an NGO, non-government organization, in order to help them till recovery. Well, my best friend, whatever the losses were caused, it was because of nature. But after destruction, this whole the situation was controlled, commanded by the sun. And then explanation of the chapter within the store in Ashma, the author Harshmande wanted to say that we should be also just like the sun, and mostly in the condition of emergency, in order to help all the persons who are in difficulty, who are in distresses, and mostly those persons who are not capable, as orphans, women, old men and children. They should be given the help, financial help, cooperation, contribution, and whatever the help may be possible, each help could be given them. Because in order to give the help is a duty of the woman. And the nation and international level is also depend upon the cooperation, upon the contribution of human life. So therefore we should also come in the category of the sun. In order to maintain humanity, as well as in order to cooperate and contribute each person, and mostly in emergency, in distresses, in difficulties. My dear student, by saying this all, from my side, today's topic is over. And tomorrow morning, I will meet you again for the next chapter. Dhanyavaad, Namaskar, Jai Hind.